The man called Bicoy surfaces at the integrated bar of the Philippines headquarters Monday, following a month of hiding after releasing videos accusing President Rodrigo Duterte and his family of links to the drug trade. He identifies himself as Peter Jomel Advincula, a former marketing executive of a Bicol-based company.
Noong Agosto 2018, nagdesisyon akong umalis at magtago. Nabuo na ang loob ko na isiwalag ang lahat ng alam ko tungkol sa sindikatong dati kong kinabibilangan. At sa tulong ng ibang mga dating kasama ko sa sindikato na gusto na ding lumabas, pinasa sa akin ang iba't ibang dokumento na kita nyo sa video. Handa po ako humarap sa anumang investigasyon ng Senado upang patutuhanan ang lahat ng inilabas ko sa video series.
He is asking for legal assistance from the IBP to sue Presidential son Paulo Duterte, longtime presidential aide and senatorial candidate Bongo, and Manasseh Scarpio, husband of Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte. IBP President Abdiel Fajardo says they have not accepted Advincula as a client so far. They still have to evaluate both his means and merit of his case. In his viral videos, Advincula claims he worked for Philippine drug syndicates and handled transaction records. He showed documents indicating multi-million peso bank transfers to accounts supposedly owned by Paulo Duterte and Waldo Carpio, brother of Manasseh Carpio. Less than a week after withdrawing his gubernatorial bid, Ilocos Norte 1st District Representative Rudy Fariñas says he is supporting the senatorial bid of his former rival, Ilocos Norte Governor Aimee Marcos. When asked if he is backing Marcos' senatorial bid, Fariñas tells reporters, quote, "Of course, she is the governor of our province, a position that I previously held for 10 years. Since she is running for the Senate, her victory would bring honor to our province." Fariñas had led a months-long congressional probe into the alleged misuse of 66.45 million pesos worth of Ilocos Norte provincial funds to purchase motor vehicles under Marcos's leadership. Since 1998, the Fariñas and Marcos families have been either allies or rivals in Ilocos Norte. In a new video released to reporters, dismissed veteran anti-drug cop Eduardo Acherto accuses the Duterte government of abducting his former anti-drug operations colleague in the Philippine National Police or PNP.
Itong mensahe na ito ay tugon sa lahat ng mga akusasyon nila laban sa akin at mga panggigipit nila sa mga tao na nakapaligid sa akin. Isa na rito si retired Major Lito Perote, na dinukot nila sa Bacolod noong Biyernes Santo.
Police have not yet determined any suspects in the kidnapping of Lito Perote. Perote contributed to the intelligence report which flagged former presidential advisor Michael Yang for drug links. Amnesty International Australia urges the Philippine Department of Justice or DOJ to drop the charges against Rappler CEO and executive editor Maria Ressa. The human rights group in a tweet says it faxed a petition with nearly 30,000 signatures requesting Philippine Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara to drop the politically motivated and trumped-up charges against Rappler and Ressa and to uphold press freedom. The petition, signed by supporters worldwide, called on the DOJ to, quote, act swiftly to uphold and protect the freedom of the press. As of March 2019, a total of 11 complaints and cases have been filed against Ressa, Rappler directors, and staff. Marvel is set to introduce its newest Filipino superhero Wave in the upcoming War of Realms, New Agents of Atlas No. 1. In the preview posted by Adventures in Poor Taste and shared by writer Greg Pak, Wave is shown responding to what she feels is a disturbance in the water, only to face off with Chinese hero Arrow, who is based in Shanghai. Arrow then turns out to be responding to a disturbance in the wind, and as the two heroes investigate the disturbances, an explosion ensues, and the rest of the story unfolds. The preview doesn't show much else of Wave, but we do get her real name is Pearl Pangan, and she is based in Cebu City.